Tesla's stock price has plummeted recently. Some people say that it is caused by the problems revealed in Tesla's previous financial report, but this is not the underlying reason. If you look at China's BYD, the stock price has been falling for 2 years. Li Auto is slightly better, but the stock price has also plummeted recently. Yellen recently visited China and said that China's electric vehicle industry and solar power industry have overcapacity, which is not groundless. This is also one of the reasons for the collapse of the electric vehicle industry stock's price. Let's get back to Tesla itself. Tesla's sales revenue before 2023 were excellent, with annual growth of about 50%. However, the annual growth in 2023 was only 17%. And this part of the growth rate came from Tesla's price reduction promotions. In other words, if Tesla does not reduce prices and do promotions, the annual growth may be less than 17%. In Tesla's financial report, the revenue proportion of its electric vehicles is too high, close to 85%. In other words, if Tesla cannot find other growth points, then Tesla can really be regarded as a traditional car company. Considering Tesla's current valuation, $450 billion US dollar market cap is quite expensive for a car manufacturer. Correspondingly, Toyota's valuation is about $310 billion US dollars. From a sales perspective, Tesla only sold about 1.8 million vehicles a year, while Toyota sold a total of more than 10 million units. In terms of gross profit margin, Tesla was about 18% in 2023, while Toyota was about 19%. Just from the perspective of selling cars, Tesla is more expensive than Toyota. So judging from the current financial report, Tesla's future growth point in electric vehicles is nothing more than Model Q or Cybertruck. But if it just sells cars, is Tesla worth the price? We will analyze the market for Model Q and Cybertruck later. The sales of FSD, which is as the advantage of Tesla, have been unsatisfactory in recent years. The market estimates that only 10% of users bought FSD. At best, the purchase rate of FSD can increase a lot. But at worst, FSD may not be what everyone needs. The buyout price of FSD has also increased in recent years, from the initial price of $5,000 to $15,000. This also makes it difficult to sell FSD. Currently, Tesla should also find that the growth of electric cars may face a bottleneck and begin to lower the selling price of FSD to expand its operating income and profits. Starting in March 2024, Elon Musk requires during delivery, the employees who deliver the car will need to demonstrate FSD to customers and provide a one-month free trial in an attempt to increase FSD sales. In addition, FSD has also reduced its price. The subscription price is reduced from $199 per month to $99 per month. In Tesla's previous sales in the United States, each Tesla standard version included a tax rebate subsidy of $3,750, while the long-distance version could have a subsidy of $7,500. This subsidy will eventually be affected by the fact that Tesla's suppliers mainly come from China and will be canceled or halved. Starting from 2024, the subsidy is halved. The subsidy for all Tesla Model 3 will be to $3,750, because the batteries of Tesla cars are not entirely made in the United States or a friendly country of the United States. Previously, this subsidy was used as a tax refund, but now it is directly refunded. That is, before 2024, consumers need to declare it themselves. If the total tax paid by the consumer is less than $7,500, there is no way to refund the $7,500. We are not sure whether this will be a good thing or a bad thing. The previous tax rebate plan was not beneficial to ordinary consumers, but beneficial to high-end consumers, because ordinary consumers may not have paid that much personal income tax at all. Therefore, this policy can theoretically promote the sales of electric vehicles in the US. The car sales in China, the United States, and Europe in 2023 were all on the rise. Tesla's sales in these regions are also rising. But its stock price is not. The problem is that Tesla's sales in Europe, judging from the data of these recent quarters, seem to have come to an end. The sales in the United States also have this momentum. Not to mention in China, the competition is very fierce and Tesla does not have an absolute advantage. In terms of the penetration rate of new electric cars, Europe and the United States still have room. The penetration rate of EV in China has exceeded 50%, while in Europe and the United States are still below 20%. But the construction level of charging stations in the United States and Europe not a good thing for Tesla in the short term. Comparing with China, there are too little. Most charging stations in the United States are concentrated in California, and the total number of charging stations in the United States is only about 640,000. About 370,000 in Europe. And more than 1.8 million in China. Why is low number of EV charging station not a good thing for Tesla? Currently, those who buy Tesla Model 3 and Model Y basically have a gasoline car at home. Model 3 and Model Y can be considered as additional purchases. Judging from the experience in China, if low-end models need to be popularized, in other words, if cheap models like Model Q can be accepted by most of the market, they need enough charging stations. Why? Because the real range of electric cars is generally only 20% off the claimed range by the vehicle makers, and if you drive on the highway, it is usually 40% off. Considering the situation in the United States, if there are not enough charging stations, it will be a disaster for low-end consumers. An EV with a 600 km range is likely to only be able to travel around 300 km on the highway. If there are not enough charging stations in the vast and sparsely populated United States, the user may have to travel dozens of kilometers before recharging, which is a waste of time and burden. Moreover, with current charging technology, it takes close to an hour to fully charge a battery of 600 km, and takes 30 minutes to charge from 20% to 80%, which is still slow. The cheap cars are for life and work. Such a waste of time and energy to charge EVs will become a burden for most of the people. This is not a good thing for the Model Q. In other words, for Model Q and Cybertruck, which shall be widely used for commuting and work, the government's construction of electric power infrastructure determines the penetration rate of such vehicles. Simply put, the penetration rate of EV in European and American is affected by the infrastructure. For countries like Europe and the United States, which do not fuel investment through high savings rate, the progress of infrastructure construction will be very slow. This is not a good thing for Tesla's stock price in the short term. If a vehicle like the Cybertruck goes into the wild without enough power, it is quite dangerous. For ordinary pickup trucks, you only need to carry a few barrels of oil at the gas station, but the Cybertruck is more difficult. On the other hand, South Korea is also a country where high savings rate drives investment like China. In other words, South Korea can also make cars very cheap. Just look at the share of Korean cars in the United States and Europe. Korean cars' share are not bad. So for people who just want to own an electric car, Korean cars can compete with Tesla at very cheap prices. After removing China's supply chain, it will be difficult for the United States to cultivate other suppliers in a short time. It will take a long time and know-how cannot be achieved in a day. The reason why Tesla's sales have been able to increase is mainly due to China's manufacturing industry chain. Tesla's production capacity has been unable to increase until it began to utilize the Chinese supply chain. From the graph, we can see that Tesla only started to increase its production capacity after the Shanghai factory was established in 2018. We have mentioned in the video discussing China's growth model that this development model improves the efficiency of investment by reducing household consumption. This is very difficult to achieve in the United States. We don't know how Tesla can overcome this in the future. As for engineering, without large amount of experiment and trial, it is difficult to generate enough know-how to meet the needs of various processes. For example, the battery management system of lithium iron phosphate, which used to be difficult to achieve voltage consistency, was mainly done in China. In the Chinese market, Tesla needs to face the overcapacity of electric vehicles in China like BYD and has to cut prices all the way. In this case, Tesla's gross profit margin and profits will continue to decline, but sales are likely to be only constant. After all, the penetration rate of electric cars in China has exceeded 50%. You can no longer expect 100% growth in this market. Tesla's FSD is difficult to compete with Chinese autonomous driving companies' product in China. First of all, judging from the current situation of autonomous driving in China, Tesla does not have an absolute advantage, especially Tesla has rejected LiDAR, which makes Tesla's purely visual solution difficult to identify static objects. Compared with the solutions of Chinese companies, Tesla may seem lagging behind. Secondly, until now, all autonomous driving companies have not been able to take full responsibility for an accident. In other words, from a legal point of view, autonomous driving is only assisted driving, which means that the responsibility still lies with the driver. So this is equivalent to the buyer paying the autonomous driving company to experiment. What is this indicating? This shows that autonomous driving is not yet mature. Early adopters will buy it, but for ordinary consumers, it will not bring any benefits to their lives. Although we are the financial and macro channel, we are actually programmers. We have used many image recognition models. We know that most recognition cannot be 100% accurate, and it is very difficult to achieve more than 95% accuracy. So the question is, assuming there is a 5% probability of death or a major accident, would you accept such a technology? What if it is 1%? And if you have watched various self-driving videos from China's XPeng, Huawei, and Li Auto, you must know what we mean. Most of these so-called autonomous driving systems actually require human monitoring, and most of the time if an accident occurs, it will be blamed on the user. Although the price reduction of FSD will increase the purchase rate and allow Tesla to increase profits in countries other than China, the future of FSD mainly depends on how to define liability legally and whether the wrong part can be 0.0001% and the loss is small enough. Finally, let's talk about the prospects of electric vehicles. It can be said that if it were not for the goal of carbon neutrality, electric vehicles' technology and sales may not advance so fast in the past few years. From the perspective of consumers, gasoline vehicles and electric vehicles are just a change in power mode from gasoline to electric. In terms of tool attributes, it doesn't change much. In addition, in some countries, electricity is not cheaper than gas, or even more expensive. This means that electric vehicles themselves do not necessarily have a cost advantage. However, if users can install a solar power generation device and store energy, then this is an advantage. From an engineering perspective, although this is beneficial to users, it increases complexity and slows down adoption. Although some people will argue that electric vehicles are more intelligent, the question is, how much value does it add to users? It can be seen from China's experience that the replacement of electric vehicles is only a replacement for the time being, and it does not bring new demand like the iPhone did when it was released. If we look forward to Tesla's future from this, we can see that it may really be just an ordinary car company. In the past, everyone's view of Tesla as a platform that electric cars were like a smartphone, and then an ecosystem was built on top of it, and the valuation was also based on this system. But now that the penetration rate of electric vehicles in China is so high, Chinese car companies have not yet built an ecosystem on the electric vehicle platform. Of course, we don't know whether Elon Musk can come up with newer things to put on Tesla to make the ecosystem come out. But for now, all electric vehicle companies are just ordinary car companies. Why do we say this? The in-car voice recognition, better car suspension system and entertainment system are more like the configurations of previous luxury cars have become cheaper, rather than new platform. When the iPhone replaced Nokia's Symbian, it completely turned the phone into an all-in-one entertainment and productive machine. The overcapacity of the electric vehicle industry in China has caused the share price of BYD, whose sales have been rising, to continue to fall, because this will lead to a decline in corporate profits. Assuming that there is no trade protection in Europe and the United States that restricts Chinese electric vehicles, perhaps Tesla's stock price will fall even more, because Tesla may need to cut prices more to compete with Chinese electric vehicles. In fact, even if there is no trade protection, Tesla's continuously increasing production capacity and slow user demand growth for electric cars like Mode 3 are already signs of overcapacity. Tesla's current production capacity is 2 million units, and demand is 1.81 million units, which is the data for April 2023, not including Tesla's Nevada Gigafactory. For Tesla, if demand cannot rise, the only way left is to cut prices. Therefore, we expect that Tesla will have to cut prices in 2024, and its gross profit margin is expected to continue to decline. In 2023, although BYD's sales have increased, almost all BYD models are reducing prices, there is excess production capacity, and there are no new growth points. It seems that Tesla will repeat the same path. BYD's current sales volume in China is more than 3 million units. It is already difficult to expand when China's domestic demand for passenger cars is about 20 million units per year. And if BYD continues to increase its production capacity, but exports and domestic demand cannot grow, BYD can only cut prices. And now BYD's production capacity in China alone has exceeded 4 million units. For companies like car companies with a relatively large proportion of fixed assets, idle production capacity will cause huge losses. As long as they can make a little gross profit, they will work hard to produce. So assuming that Tesla's growth in Europe and the United States is slow and its planned production capacity is too large, will it follow the same path? Although we are not very optimistic about Tesla, there may be some new changes in the market that we have not considered. For example, we have not yet talked about Tesla's robotaxi and solar energy business in this video. These business may be good for Tesla. If you are interested in our videos, please subscribe.